four Gospels record many of Jesus' healings throughout his ministry. And one would agree that healing was an important part of Jesus' ministry, although it was not the primary reason for which he came. But Jesus certainly was open to it being a part of the fulfillment of the mission for which he was sent by God to do. Today's Gospel reading of the healing of the blind man outside the village of Bethsaida is one of those healings or miracles performed by our Lord. It is only recorded in Mark's Gospel and not the other three. Today's passage begins with Jesus and his disciples coming to Bethsaida, and some folks brought a blind man to him and begged him to touch him. Bethsaida was a village located upon, under, or near the upper Jordan River on the east bank of the Sea of Galilee. And as Jesus was on the upper Galilean stretch of his ministry, he would have visited this village and was greeted with people who had heard about him and his miraculous healings and wanting to experience it for themselves. They may not have even known that Jesus was the Messiah, but just wished to see if what they had heard was true. So what do? They brought a blind man and begged Jesus to touch him. They could have genuinely cared for this blind man, and by bringing him to Jesus, they truly wanted to see his sight restored. Or they could have brought the man just to see Jesus perform a miracle before their very eyes. We are not sure as to their motives, but they either believed that Jesus could do what they had heard he can do, or they were testing him to see if he can really do it. Nevertheless, regardless of their motives, the blind man may not have gotten to meet Jesus and be healed without the help of others. Whether it was due to a lack of faith or just that he didn't know where to go to be healed by Jesus. And this speaks to us as individuals today. Sometimes we too need others to assist us when we are lacking in our faith or when our spiritual nature is not what is expected to be. And so we need the love and care, the encouragement and faith of others to help us get through moments like these, to have them pray with and for us, and to feel Jesus' healing touch through them. But this particular healing is different from most healings that Jesus did. There is an oddity or a strangeness, an extraordinariness in the way the healing was done. Normally, when Jesus healed folks, he did it in the presence of everyone, except in cases like Jairus' daughter, where he sent the people, except the girl's parents, out of the room before raising her from the dead. In this case of healing the blind man, Jesus chose not to heal the man with everyone observing. Instead, he took the blind man by the hand and led him out of the village. Jesus didn't need to touch him. He could have just said the words, and the man would have been healed. But our Lord went to the trouble of taking the man by the hand and walking with him until they got out of the village. And we are not told if anyone followed them or if the disciples were near. But what is important to note is that Jesus intentionally sought to be alone with this man. And we are not sure why Jesus did this. Was it because Jesus felt the blind man lacked the faith? Was it because he didn't wish the people to see because they were not genuine in their reason for bringing this man to him? But what it does tell us is that we oftentimes grow in faith when we are spending alone time with God. We oftentimes grow in faith when we are spending alone time with God. It is an important aspect of maturing in our spiritual life which is why it is vital to spend time alone with God. Jesus did it when he walked this earth, and we should do the same. And then we read that Jesus put saliva on this man's eyes and laid his hands on him, and he asked him, "Can you see anything?" And the man looked up and said, "I can see people, but they look like trees walking." What was the reason for the saliva? And furthermore, why did Jesus have to ask the man if he could see anything? Of course, Jesus knew if he could see or not. But it would appear that the blind man knew the difference between people and trees, which means that he was not always blind. He was not born blind. He previously had his sight. And thus something may have caused him to go blind, and the reason for the saliva may have been to soothe whatever pain or damage that happened to his eyes that caused him not to see. And the third oddity to this healing is that Jesus did not heal this man in the first instance. Jesus did not fully heal the eyes of the blind man the first time, which is very different from the other times when our Lord healed others in his first effort, in his first trial. What was that all about? And one thing we need to realize is that Jesus' miracles of healing always had a reason and a purpose. And therefore, there was a purpose why our Lord felt he had to do this healing in stages. And we are not to think that Jesus' miraculous or healing powers were waning or that he made a mistake, but there was a need for Jesus to do this miracle partially with the first step and then completely with the second one. Jesus wished to show the blind man that he loved and cared for him, that he had compassion toward him and wanted to see the man mature in his faith and belief about God and to accept who he was. Jesus wished to bring this man into a closer relationship with him and with the Father. My friend, Jesus knows us, and he knows our faith level, and he is willing to work at our level, where we are in our faith, where we are in our spiritual journey. Once we are open to his intervening in our lives and helping us to grow in faith and in our spiritual lives. And sometimes for this to happen, for us to connect with God, takes place on a personal level, one-on-one with him, just between you and him, all alone with him. And in those moments, we feel the loving, caring, and compassionate nature of God, who is there to soothe our pain and to help us see and experience the presence of God in our lives. May we be open and embrace those wonderful opportunities when God presents himself to us to experience his love and his care and his compassion and to grow closer in our relationship with him. Amen.